Hi! In this video, we will introduce the trigonometric functions. Trigonometric functions arise in periodic phenomena, such as acoustic waves and water waves, and also in circular movements, such as a big wheel or Ferris wheel. Here we see the London Eye, also called the Millennium Wheel, since it was built at the occasion of the Millennium Change at the year 2000. At that time, it was the world's largest Ferris wheel. Its height is 135 meters, it contains 32 closed cabins, and it takes 30 minutes for one tour. The height of a cabin of the London Eye as a function of time can be described by means of trigonometric functions. Let us assume that at time t is zero, a cabin is in its lowest position so that people are able to enter. Furthermore, we assume that the big wheel turns at a constant speed and that it takes 30 minutes for a complete tour. After 7.5 minutes, the cabin has reached half of its maximum height, and after 50 minutes, it is at its highest position. Then the cabin is going down, and after 22.5 minutes, it is back at half of its maximum height. After 30 minutes, it is back down at its lowest position. From there, the movement is repeated, and we end up with a periodic function. The trigonometric functions are usually defined as the ratio of two sides in a rectangular triangle. For the acute angle theta, we have the sine of theta is the length of the opposite side divided by the length of the hypotenuse. The cosine of theta is the length of the adjacent side divided by the length of the hypotenuse. And the tangent is the length of the opposite side divided by the length of the adjacent side, which equals the sine of theta divided by the cosine of theta. In mathematics, angles are usually measured in radians instead of degrees. The angle of a complete revolution contains 360 degrees, which is equal to 2 pi radians. The number pi is a quite complicated number, which is close to 3.14. So we have pi radians equals 180 degrees. This implies that 1 radian equals 180 over pi degrees, and that 1 degree equals pi over 180 radians. If we consider a sector with angle theta in a circle with radius r, then the length of the arc s equals theta divided by 2 pi times the circumference 2 pi r of the complete circle, which is the radius r multiplied by the angle theta. If we take a circle with radius 1, then the arc S is equal to the angle theta measured in radians. Since the trigonometric functions only depend on the ratio of two sides of a rectangular triangle, we might draw this triangle inside a circle with radius 1, being the hypotenuse of the triangle. This circle is called the unit circle. Then we have, for an acute angle theta, that the value of the sine can be found at the vertical axis, and the value of the cosine at the horizontal axis. Both are positive for acute angles. The value of the tangent is the indicated height at the vertical line tangent to the circle, which explains its name. In this way, we can collect the values of the trigonometric functions for special values of the angle theta between 0 and pi over 2. We consider the angles 0, pi over 6, pi over 4, pi over 3, and pi over 2. For the sine, we obtain these values using the vertical axis, and for the cosine, we obtain these values using the horizontal axis. Then the value of the tangent is obtained by the ratio of the sine and the cosine. Of course, this does not exist for theta is pi over 2, since then the cosine is equal to 0. Now the unit circle can be used to define both the sine and the cosine for other values of the angle theta as well. For instance, consider theta is equal to 2 pi over 3, This angle is indicated in the picture, and we have to determine the indicated values of at the horizontal and the vertical axis. Note that the value of the cosine at the horizontal axis is negative, and that the value of the sine at the vertical axis is positive. In this way, we can find the values of the sine and the cosine for all special values of the angle theta in the unit circle. Let us look at an example. If we want to find the value of the cosine of 5 pi over 6, we make a turn with an angle of 5 pi over 6 in the positive direction, which is counterclockwise, till we have reached 5 pi over 6 on the unit circle. Now we look at the horizontal axis and obtain the value minus 1/2 times the square root of 3. For the value of the sine of 5 pi over 6, we look at the vertical axis and obtain the value plus 1/2. Now the value of the tangent is the quotient of the sine and the cosine, which is equal to plus 1/2 divided by minus 1/2 times the square root of 3, which simplifies to minus 1/3 times the square root of 3. Another example. If we want to find the value of the cosine of minus 2 pi over 3, we make a turn with an angle of 2 pi over 3 in the negative direction, which is clockwise, till we have reached minus 2 pi over 3 on the unit circle. Now we look at the horizontal axis and obtain the value minus 1/2. For the value of the sine of minus 2 pi over 3, we look at the vertical axis and obtain the value minus 1/2 times the square root of 3. Now the value of the tangent is the quotient of the sine and the cosine, which is equal to minus 1/2 times the square root of 3 divided by minus 1/2, which simplifies to the square root of 3. Finally, we look at the graphs of the trigonometric functions. Both the cosine and the sine are defined for all real values of the angle, which is the argument of the function. The graph of the cosine looks like this, and the graph of the sine like this. Since the tangent is the ratio of the sine and the cosine, it is well defined for all values of x for which the cosine is not equal to 0. At the zeros of the cosine, the graph has vertical asymptotes. In the next video, we will cover the main properties of these trigonometric functions, as well as their rules of calculation. Good luck with the exercises.